Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity. Blind. Ikantha is in there. We can't kill her or actually do much to her.
Sure.
So let's continue on. Back. I think we killed everything in here, but we still hear those things grinding their teeth. Back here is the tower. The mysterious tower. That we don't know that much about. But apparently, furthering the main quest. I'm gonna turn fast mode off now.
Time to see and not be seen.
Time to speak the words. The massive stone door of the tower is sealed, and it doesn't appear to be any way of opening. Speak the words you learn from the Leaden Key Acolyte. You hear rumbles and clanks from hidden tumblers as the door unlocks. Go on, Kanna, say it. Hello? Hello? Place full of undead. Of course. I'm not even gonna bother with the ranged. Knock down. Boom. Attack. Boom. Fiery sword. Boom. Durance run up. DS run up.
Eh?
Get to the top of the tower. Okay, we stop running forward. Boom. Holy Radiance. Amplified Thrust. Off of... who? Myself? Durance? Why are our fighters back here? Skeletal Wizard back there.
He lost you.
Soul Shock off of... Kanna? Durance? Aloth? Okay. Making sure everyone's where they're supposed to be. Some fire. Go boom. That wasn't fire, arcane assault, I meant. I said fire. I don't know why.
Following your lead.
Chop him up so we can get that wizard. Ooh. Ooh, what's he doing? Oh, necrotic lance. Ah, nasty. Hello, sir. Oh, and goodbye. Kind of anticlimactic, wasn't it? Looking forward to tearing him apart, and he just falls. Rod and a vessel bone. Boom, boom. Alright.
Got it.
Yeah, sneaking just in case. Open. Traps and stuff. Hidden stuff. Ooh, very interesting. Crumpled page from Aldhelm's journal. Who mentioned this Aldhelm? What's her name? This must be the guy who's behind it all? Or one of them. Day 7, a week of study and we're still none the wiser about this device. Trindig remains optimistic. I don't know what I'd do without his spirit. Literally? And Trindig's letter. Dearest Mother and Father, you will be pleased to hear that I've learned much already since coming to the city. There are many incredible ruins nearby, and Master Greg has allowed me to accompany him on a number of expeditions. I am writing to you inside an ancient Inguithan tower. There's an entire district built up around it, but the locals have mostly left the tower untouched. They have let us set up temporary living quarters here so our work can continue uninterrupted. Okay. That's their first mistake. It is an unsettling place at times, but Master Greg has been a constant comfort, and he is quick to remind me that the things we learn from this tower may one day help us find a cure for Widewind's legacy. I'd better get some rest now. Mr. Greg likes to get an early start to the day. All my love, Trindig. Interesting. Essence shimmers and pulsates within this strange device. The mattress is lumpy and smells of old straw, but whoever slept here last made it neatly. Ooh. Oh, right in there. It's a revenant. They work rather slowly. Let's set up our crossbows. And yeah, I keep checking GOG.com. Still no update 2.0. As I record this, it's... I know you're seeing this much later. But it's the 13th. August 13th right now. So... I try to get a backlog going because I juggle two games at once because I'm insane like that. So I can't run behind. Yeah, but as of the 13th, still nothing on GOG, at least the morning of the 13th anyway. Have at thee, Revenant. I'll fry your butt. They're not that tough. Used to be.
That's it!
What's this thing? Oh, Skeletal Ranger. That thing's almost dead. I said just slash at him. Go ranged for a little bit. Yeah, wizard that is. Knock down.
Yeah.
You got rid of two of them already? Kill Revenant.
Don't.
Nice. Hello, Skeletal Ranger. Aloth? I thought I... Well, I might as well just keep it. Orbo. Vessel Bone.
Got it.
Sneaking so to find special things.
Be cautious. Be constant.
Traps. Which undead somehow walk over. A potion of power. Excellent. 20 golden dukes. And another page from Aldhelm's journal. Day 2. We've completed our measurements of the machine, thanks to Trindig's youthful agility. Further examination is required to discover its intended use. Alright. So we've got some kind of Slender Man of Eternity going on here with all the pages. I'll piece them together, I guess I'll, you know, maybe I'll read through them again if I find them all. When I find them all, whatever. Stairs up. And Skeletal Wizard. You know what? He's gonna hit us from spells from afar, so I'd say just... attack!
Yeah.
Got a fighter and a ranged rogue, that won't be too much trouble. Shouldn't be. Oh, ouch. Maybe. Alright, let's put some of our spells to use here. Some more healing over here.
What?
Soul shock. Take that. That's what we think of that. Standard fare. Alright, Sarah's up.
Got it.
Oh, see that? As soon as we go into sneaking
be
mode.
Quiet as a calm sea.
246 copper.
Which is not very quiet.
What is this hole? I don't trust that hole. Nevertheless, I will walk past it. Because even though I don't trust it, I still want to see what it does, if anything. More sleeping quarters. Padding the scratchy old coverlet thickens the air with dust. No one has used this bed in weeks. 63 silver. The rest of these letters. Looks like we've explored all of level one already. Up we go.
Laying low.
And climb high. Hello? These guys are like undead themselves or something like that. It's the upper part of the device. Oh! A Dargul. Since they don't actually run, we should be able to get a couple shots off. Eventually we're gonna have to rest, too. There's that. Look how it flashed there for a second. That was pretty cool.
Raised out the lot you leave.
Alright. Who's got their weapon raised? Might as well let that arrow fly. Thank you. 25 thrust off of Palagina. Dare. Knock down. I believe Durance can let his arrow fly. Hit that thing. And hit that thing. Fiery version. And his arrow flew. So there we go. Now he can protect us. Oh, there's more. Alright, Aeloth. Again. She's gotten a lot of... She still has plenty of this, so yeah, another amplified thrust off of Adair this time. More flamings! All the flamings! What's a big Ravenan? Isn't he look bigger? He looks bigger. All the bigs. Throw another arcane assault in. Did I see Chunkage? I thought I saw Chunkage. Amplified thrust again. Oh, that was Chunkage, definitely. Ghoul is near death. Yeah, keep on keeping on. Run around and get the ghoul. Just stand. You can't get around? Oh, crap. Well, we got one left. Mind the chunks, guys. It's really hard to get the blood off those boots like that. Normal stuff.
Eh?
A. Now, we were gonna read before we were so rudely interrupted.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
And read books. Or maybe not. Potion of deleterious alacrity of motion. +50% attack speed for 30 seconds. But -11 endurance. +2 move speed for 30 seconds. Caster draws upon his or her life force to gain an increase to speed and movement while draining his own endurance. Well, that actually makes sense. Energy's got to come from somewhere, you know. Went to Adair and 181 copper. Let's see what we got here. I haven't used any of these potions. Saving them for a special occasion, I guess.
Sure.
Ah, that's why we're sneaking.
Something over there.
Oh yeah, over there. A scroll of protection. And a scroll of restore light endurance. Awesome. I didn't mean to hit that. The scroll contains a pen and ink diagram of the Aedra device running through the tower. Despite copious measurements and carefully drawn detail, it gives no indication of the machine's purpose. There's another one. We'll read that in a second. We should just clear out this whole room before we even start looking at anything, but... Oh, you know how it is. Yeah. Never mind. I don't know, I got stuck there for a sec. Ready, boys? And girls?
Brave Dalcilot, you leave.
Almost dead. Again. All the dyings. Alright. Knock down on the big guy here. Hit the big guy. Holy Radiance. Fiery Doom. I know, you can just keep sticking to the standbys. Amplified Thrust, I like. I find that a lot of her spells are really specialized, so... I just fell over. Durance killed it with holy with holy radiance. That's kind of badass, I think. I know there's more of you.
Yes.
Yes.
Thanks.
Again. Unusual. Let's look at this table. The Works of the Inguithans, a comprehensive guide. I would read it.
Keeping an eye out.
You know. You guys know I would read it.
Indeed.
Indeed. He agrees. Eloth even agrees. Admeth Hadrit Part 1, Rites of Power, 310 copper. Alright, so it's a brownish book. Speaking of reading things. I think... I might have read it? I'm not sure. No, I guess not, but why is it up here? Part one. You figure it would collect down the bottom. I don't know. Little could one know that the man who once destroyed part of his own country with fire would become the Deerwood's most beloved leader. Martyred in the war he started to free his people from an oppressive rule, there isn't a Deerwooden who doesn't know of or revere Admeth for what he did. Strangely, even though there are records of his father Edrang's childhood, and even though he was raised in nobility in the Deerwood, while it was still a Deer territory, information about Admeth's early years is nearly impossible to find. Admeth is not known for his childhood, though. He is known for saving the Deerwood and uniting it with its sworn enemy, the Glamfellens. At 2652, the Deerwood in troubles with their fair coning were at a boiling point. Several of the earls under Edrang's rule, provoked by the imperial court in Edir, resumed looting the ruins around Deerwood that the Glamfellens held sacred. When the Glamfellens finally retaliated, it was overwhelmingly brutal and resulted in a slave uprising. Galvin Regd, whom Edrang has fought before, resumed control of the Glamfellen troops. Regd was also able to convince some of the Dalemgan to join the fight. His words, man. Edrang was, at this point, far too old to lead his forces into battle, so he sent his son Admeth in his place to contain the threat. Admeth, true to form as the son of Edrang, and obviously having learned tactics from his father, made a dangerous but effective tactical decision. In order to prevent Regd troops from... using the woods as cover, and to keep them from advancing through his land, Set fire to the forest as tributary, at a tributary of the Isuar River, and position his troops to prevent any of the Glanfathan forces from retreating. This tactic proved to be effective. While some Glanfathans and Dilemkin were able to escape, thousands died. In the skirmish that followed, Galvin Regd was captured and sent to be held in New Harrimar. Admeth was able to do what his father spent decades trying to do. He stopped Galvin Regd. The conflict with the Glanfathans continued for several months, and Admeth repeated this scorched earth tactic several times to flush the opposing forces from key battlefields. He was able to bring the conflict to an... There's a lot of typos in this one. To an end before the year ended. While it was a win for the Deerwoodens, it was very costly as well. Because of his tactics, the conflict earned the name the War of the Black Trees. Or the War of Black Trees. After Edrang's death in 2654, Admeth became the Gref of the Deerwood to the dismay of the Imperial Court and the other earls. Over the course of the next year, they defied his rule at every turn, rebuking his decrees and countermanding his directives. At 2655 AI, Admeth had had enough. Even though he lacked support from most of the earls, he was admired by both the Valian dukes and all the common folk. Backed by this support, he issued an ultimatum to the Faerconing to anoint him a Gref Palatine. The Faerconing, unwilling to deal with a rebellion while trying to establish a new Vorlas trade in Red Saras, agreed. Admeth then held authority and legal power over the earls, their holdings, and their titles. The Deerwood was no longer a Grefram, but instead was a Palatinate. This change reduced the Faerconing's power over the region. With his new power, Admeth quickly brought the rebellious earls into line. But in exchange for the power, Admeth invested time and money into all of the Deerwood's ports and trade posts, dramatically increasing shipping traffic. This helped the earls and brought in more money for the Faerconing. Okay. Done. I don't remember exactly what a Faerconing is. Some kind of ruler of some kind. Two peridot and 202 copper. Okay, maybe there are no more undeads in here. Maybe. Don't know for sure. A scroll of fireball. Nice. Just giving it to Palagina because, as you can see, he has no room. Page from Aldham's journal. Found another page! Slender Man will be pleased. Day 11. Finally got out of the tower to clear our heads. Beasts take the patrons. We'll finish the study on our own terms, our own time. Just as I said as much to Trindig, the sky came to life with stray lighting. I said it's a good omen, but the poor lad's spooked. Only cure for that is a good night's sleep. And then when you wake up... Undeadville. another undead. Another one of those big revenants. I suppose it's a, what do you call it? It's an Amawa revenant. I guess. They seem rather big. And I don't think they're all that big.
Yeah.
Let your arrows fly. Who's standing apart like that? Well, it's me. Huh?
Brave does the Lord believe.
Alright. See that? How damaged it is already. It's already more than half dead. Okay, I guess there's stairs over here. The game's just trying to tell us, hey, stairs, stairs. No, fight, fight. Let's go range for a while. Let him use his rod. Well, that was easy.
Let's see what lies this way.
Don't even have any goodies. Okay, those are the stairs, obviously. Any goodies around here? Nope. Can I look at this thing again? From up here now? The pulling, pounding energy in the machine feels even stronger up here. I see. $39. Folded page from Aldhelm's journal. Well, this one's folded. Day 10. Patrons grow impatient with the lack of quantifiable results. They should drag themselves out of their mansions and spend a few nights here if they think it's so easy. That's all he writes all day. Ooh, yeah. I didn't realize that was a table. I'm like, what the hell is that? Some kind of seal on the ground. Sigil of the Arcane. It's a ring with 800 copper. Arcane Dampener grants Arcane Dampener. Okay. What is Arcane Dampener? Plus one intellect as well. Rings can feature, yeah, basic description of rings. And it tells me what a spellbind means, but not what Arcane Dampener is. Does it mean spells can't affect you as much? We have so many rings, though. Letter from Ikantha. Aldhelm, I did indeed receive your recent summons, as well as the two that came before it. I'd been waiting for you to present yourself on my doorstep so that I could give you my answer in person, a firm and unwavering no. I won't help you. In fact, I relish the idea of you and your team of glorified engineers sitting in that tower, sweating over the runes I've studied for years. Nothing gives me greater pleasure than knowing that my research, which you've long disparaged, is the missing piece in your mundane little puzzle. As you well know, its knowledge I've always valued. I'm just around the corner. I encourage you to find me should you wish to rehash this conversation in person. Yours truly, Ikantha. Okay, so she definitely would not help him. And she's, sorry guys, feeding on people. To keep herself from being a typical stupid undead thing. Okay, I guess we're done with this level. Oh, wow. And my, how the time flies. Gotta call in an episode here. Stay tuned for next episode when we explore level 3 of the mysterious tower with the mysterious artifact and all the little notes and stuff like that that we'll find along the way and undead. And thanks for watching. See you next time and enduring. Grow strong.